Hello everyone, so in this lecture we'll see some basic binomial identities as well as what is binomial expansions and all. Okay, so let us begin with some binomial expansions and identities which are helpful in generating functions. So immediately next topic will be the generating function. So these identities and expansions will be the helpful in the combinatorics, okay, or in the remaining part. So some basic things from binomial expansions we'll see. Okay, first one, yes, everybody knows about binomial expansion. Yes, what is the binomial expansion of x plus y raised to power n? That is, we can say that summation r from 0 to n, we can write it ncr x raised to power r, y raised to power n minus r. And that is also equal to r equals to 0 to n, ncr, we can say that x raised to power n minus r, y raised to power r. It is, we can say that yes, if we expand this one nc0 x power 0 y power n plus nc1, then we can say that x power 1 y raised to power n minus 1 up to, we can say that this is ncn x raised to power n and y raised to power 0. You can observe one thing from here. Yes, everywhere we can say that sum of, yes, powers of x and y is equal to n always. Yes or no? Isn't it? Okay. I hope this one is clear to everyone. One more thing is also there. Yes, what is the alternating plus minus sum? Yes, what is means NC0 minus, or you only tell me, let me see once, x raised to power 0, or we'll see it later. Okay. So I already explained that one also. But before that, write down some problems. Write down first one. Yes, find the number of coefficients in the expansion of x plus y raised to power n. So guys, you know how to find the, yes, you only tell me how to find the total number of coefficients. Yes, you can see here every term, yes, we can say that x raised to power n1, y raised to power n2. So everywhere we can say that n1 plus n2 will be equal to n or not. Now you only tell me if it is equal to n. So we can say that the number of solutions of this equation or number of total combinations will be the, yes, we can say that total number of terms. And every term has a coefficient. Okay, so yes, we can say that this problem reduces to the n minus 1 plus RCR. Yes or no? In that particular formula or not? Yes, we find the, yes, we will find the total, yes, solutions of this equation, that will be the answer or not? Yes. So here we can say that R value is n and number of variables are 2. So n value is 2. So we can put in this formula, so 2 minus 1 plus ncn, this is n plus 1 cn, so it is n plus 1. So answer will be the n plus 1. Also you can observe nc0, nc1 up to ncn, so r value starts with 0 and ends at n, so 0 to n count value will be the n plus 1. So we can say that total number of, yes, coefficients will be the n plus 1. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, write down next question. What is next question? Yes, write down what is the coefficient of x cube y raised to power 2 in the expansion of, yes, we can say that x plus y raised to power 5. Raised to power 5. So we can say that coefficient will be what? 5c3 x raised to power 3 y power 2. Yes or no? So this 2 is 5 minus 3. Now you only tell me what is the coefficient. So we can say that 5C3, so 10 is the answer. Isn't it? Next question, you only tell me, write down next one. Yes, what is the coefficient of x square y raised to power 6 in the expansion of x plus y raised to power 10? Now you only tell me, guys, yes, what will be the answer? So you can say that 10c2 x raised to power 2 y raised to power will be 10 minus 2, that is 8. So we can say that this particular expression does not exist in this expansion. So what will be the answer? Yes, isn't it? Answer will be what? We can say that yes, what is the coefficient? That means we can say that answer is 0. Why? Because 0 is multiplied with x square y power 6, then this becomes yes 0. That's why this term is not there in the expansion of that one. So we can say that what would be the coefficient? We can say that 0, because after multiplying with 0, this term becomes 0, entire term becomes 0. So because of coefficient 0, we can say that this is yes, answer is 0. Or in this expansion, write down yes one more term, 0 into x square y power 6. Yes, that is correct or not? Yes, that's why we can say that coefficient is 0. So remember, guys, don't do the mistake of saying that coefficient does not exist. Yes, coefficient is existing, that is 0. Isn't it? Okay. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, write down next problem. Next one is, what is the coefficient of x raised to power minus 15 in x square plus 1 by x cube raised to power 10? That is the next question. Now, what will be the solution? Yes, we can write it like that or not. Yes, that is x raised to power minus 3 raised to power 10. Now this can be written like that. Yes, we can say that r from 0 to 10. Yes, this one is x, this is y. So write in the same manner. Yes, first term, that is x raised to power r. Yes or no? And y raised to power 10 minus r. So here we can say that this becomes what? R is 0 to 10. Then this is, we can say that 10 cr. Yes or no? Yes, here 10 cr will also be there. Into, we can say that x raised to power 2r into x raised to power minus 30 plus 3r. So ultimately, this becomes what? We can say that r is 0 to 10, 10 cr, and this becomes x raised to 5 power minus 30. Now, we need to find out the coefficient of x raised to power minus 15. So equate 5r minus 10 with minus 15. So from there we can say that 5r minus 30 equals to minus 15. So r equals to 3 or not? Yes, r equals to 3. So we can say that 10 cr, that is the coefficient. So put r value equals to 3. So we can say that 10 c3 will be the required coefficient. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, so that was the, yes, we can say that binomial expansion. Now we'll see some trinomial, or we can say that multinomial expansion. Okay, so write down next one, multinomial expansion. Yes, we'll see what is multinomial expansion. Let us say x1 plus x2 up to, let's say, xt. Yes, these are the terms. We can say that t number of terms are there and raised to power n is there. So yes, we can say that summation, yes, q1 plus q2 up to, we can say that qt equals to n. Yes, that is the summation, n factorial divided by q1 factorial into q2 factorial up to qt factorial. Into, we can say that x1 raised to power q1 into x2 raised to power q2 up to, we can say that xt raised to power qt. So that will be the expansion of, we can say that, the multinomial, isn't it? Okay. That will be the, yes, we can say that expansion. Yes or no? Let us consider one example. What is the meaning of this one? Let's say x plus y plus z raised to power 3. So what is the expansion of this one? So first term we can write down 3 factorial divided by, yes, q1, q2, qt. We can take any value. So we can take 0 factorial, 0 factorial, 3 factorial. Some of these must be what? N? Yes, this is N or not? Yes. Isn't it? 0 plus 0 plus 3, that is 3 only. Into, we can write down x power 0 into y power, yes, 0, z power 3. Plus one more combination will be there, that is 0 factorial, 1 factorial, 2 factorial. Yes, then we can say that x raised to power 0, y raised to power 1, z raised to power 2, and so on. So, yes, here we can say that these are, 0 is what? Q1. And Q2 is what? We can say that 0. Q3 is 3 in this particular, yes, we can say that coefficient, and so on. So we can say that Q1 plus Q2 plus up to Qt, that sum will be equal to n. So total number of combinations that will satisfy this condition, yes, those many number of terms will be there in this particular expansion. Isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, so depending on that, write down first problem. Yes, let's say find the number of terms in the expansion of x plus y plus z equal raised to power 10. Now you only tell me here the combinations will be Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, that must be equals to 10. So now this problem reduces to what? We can say that, yes, we need to find out the solution of this one. So we can say that here this can be reduced in n minus 1 plus RCR or not? Yes. Here we can say that number of variables are 3 and R value is 10. So total number of ways or combinations will be how many? Yes, we can say that 3 minus 1 plus 10 C10, that is 12 C10. So we can say that 66 is the correct answer. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Isn't it? Isn't it? Okay. This one, I think this one is clear to everyone. Okay. Write down next one. Let's say, what is the coefficient of x cube y raised to power 7 in the expansion of, we can say that, x plus y plus z raised to power 10. That is the question. Now you only tell me, yes, we can say that, yes, x raised to power 10. So we can say that x cube y raised to power 7, then z will be what? 0. So what will be the, yes, we can say that coefficient, that will be the 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 7 factorial, 0 factorial. So that will be the, yes, that will be the 120. That is your correct answer. Isn't it? Okay. Write down next concept. What is the next concept? You only tell me. Next one is what? Yes. Write down one note. In that note, you can write down first one. Yes, you only tell me if binomial expansion is there, then what is the expansion NC0? Then x raised to power 0, y raised to power n, plus NC1, x raised to power 1, y raised to power n minus 1. Yes, then NC2, x square, y raised to power n minus 2, up to, we can say that NCN, x raised to power n, y becomes 0. Now you only tell me, if we talk about the coefficients, now you only tell me what is the sum of coefficients. So here we can say that NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 up to, let's say, NCN. So you guys know, yes, very well, the sum of this one is 2 raised to power n. Isn't it? So why these two came? Because, yes, in this expansion, two variables are there, x and y. That's why it is 2 raised to power n. If it is, yes, we can say that trinomial means x plus y plus z, then the sum will be the 3 raised to power n, and so on. I hope this one is clear to everyone. So write down generalized formula, the summation of, yes, we can say that the summation of all multinomial coefficients, yes, these are the, yes, we can say that coefficients n factorial divided by q1 factorial, q2 factorial up to qt factorial. Yes, we can say that here what will be the condition, q1 plus q2 up to qt must be equal to n. So sum of all these coefficients will be what? Here we assumed the t number of variables, so sum will be what? T raised to power n only, isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, so you can write down, yes, if it is asked to you guys, find the sum of all the coefficients in the expansion of, this is given to you, let's say x plus y plus z plus p raised to power, let's say 12. So what will be the answer? We can say that here four variables are there, so we can say that 4 raised to power n, here n value is 12. So 4 raised to power 12 will be the correct answer. Isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. And one more thing, I already told you guys that, but you can remember this one also. Yes, you only tell me. Yes, you only tell me. Yes, NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 plus NC3. Yes, up to we can say that NCN, this sum is 2 raised to power n. Now next identity, NC0 alternating plus minus sign, then sum becomes what? We can say that then sum becomes what? 0. Isn't it? Sum becomes 0. So from here we can write down NC0 plus NC2, yes, plus NC4, yes, dash dash dash, yes or no? Isn't it? And then we can say that this sum is equal to NC1 plus NC3 plus NC5 and so on. Isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Yes or no? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay. So we can say that sum of these, we can say that even part is equal to sum of odd part. Yes or no? These two sums are equal. That's why this overall sum becomes what? Alternating plus minus sign. Then we add all these with alternating plus minus sign, then it becomes a 0. Now can you tell me what will be the sum of this one? You only tell me sum of this one will be what? 2 raised to power n divided by 2. This is the half of the sum. This is also half of the sum. So this one is also, we can say that 2 raised to power n divided by 2. And that is, we can say that 2 raised to power n minus 1, this is also 2 raised to power n minus. And sum of these 2's will be what? We can say that is 2 raised to power n minus 1 plus 2 raised to power n minus 1, that is, we can say that is 2 raised to power n only. Yes, that is also correct. Okay, so these are some, we can say that basic identities. Okay, yes, that will be useful in generating function. Okay. So everything, whatever we learned for, let's say, in the summation and some binomial identities and expansions, these will be helpful in generating functions somewhere else. Or in, we can say that wherever, yes, these type of problems will be there, easily you can understand the concept. Okay. Okay. So next one, sometimes you will see, let's say this is x plus y raised to power n. So we can write it like that or not. Let's say NC0, yes, x raised to power 0, y raised to power n, NC1, then x raised to power 1, y raised to power n minus 1, up to we can say that NCn, x raised to power n, y raised to power 0. We can say that we can replace yes, y with 1, so it becomes this one. We can write it like that or not. Now this becomes what? Yes, substitute one variable equals to one. So no problem at all. This becomes NC0. Then we can say that this is, yes, x raised to power 0. Then we can say that NC1, x raised to power 1. Then NC2, then we can say that x square, up to we can write down NCn, x raised to power n, no problem at all, yes or no? So that becomes the, yes, we can say that the next expansion and so on, isn't it? I hope this one is clear to everyone. Sometimes it will be replace, we can say that this one, then this one can be written like this or not? Yes, we can write it like that, yes or no? Now expand. Okay, so every variety you can cover easily. So that's all about, we can say that some identities in binomial and binomial expansion. And we'll also see in, yes, what is multinomial and all. Okay, so I hope this one is clear to everyone. So in the next lecture onward, we'll start some important, we can say that one important concept, that is a generating function. Okay, guys. Okay, I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay, thank you so much.